Somebody yelled, "Do that again." No, I just taught you. Listen, I can only teach you one. I'm not feeling that mellow, you know. A lot of people, when I do these kind of things, they say, "Gee, Harry, you know, you can use these things in poker, right?" I said, "Well, yeah, people don't want to play poker. I get a lot of partners. I very rarely get opponents, you know, when I'm in Las Vegas. But I might, since I'm on this kick of teaching you a few things, would you like to see how I learned how to cheat at poker?" Okay. Again, that doesn't mean you're going to learn how to do it, let's be honest. But, you know, you won't be able to do it. I told you before, it's some misspent youth. It's 40 years of practice. I was in Reno, Nevada, as a matter of fact, but it's a long time ago. And I was sitting at the table waiting for somebody. It was a long time ago. I wasn't married yet. I was waiting for a girl, to be honest, as long as I'm telling you the story. And I was doing some fancy stuff with the cards like this. And there was a guy sitting, an older man, looked like I do now, you know, gray hair, older guy. Came over to me and he said, "Hey, son, I see you can handle cards pretty well." I said, "Yeah, I play around." He said, "How would you like to learn how to cheat at poker?" I said, "Well, I'd love to. You know, I'm always willing to learn." He said, "Here's what you got to do, kid." He said, "You got to get the four aces to the bottom of the deck." He didn't tell me how to do that. He just said, "Get them to the bottom of the deck." He said, "Then, when you deal out, let's say you're in a five-hand poker game," he said, "you do what is called in the parlance of the trade a bottom deal." He said, "So what you do is you come around like this and you take the bottom card, which is an ace. So if you can learn how to do that, if you want to practice, obviously you're going to be able to win all the time. When you come to your fifth card, it doesn't much matter. You already have the four aces, so it doesn't matter which card you take. And, of course, you'll have the four aces, obviously." He said, "Do you think you could do that?" He was a bit of a wise guy. I said, "Well, you know, I'd like to try, but I don't like the idea of having the four aces on the bottom of the deck. I like to keep them right here in the middle. I'm going to bury them among these cards right here. So they're really, really buried, you know, the aces. I don't know if you, there you go, you can see them right in the middle." And I said, "I like to, when I'm playing cards, give the deck a shuffle, which you forgot. You forgot to shuffle the deck." And I said, "Mostly what you forgot is to cut the deck. When you're playing, you have to cut." I said, "When I deal around the five cards, I don't want to take the cards from the bottom. I want to take them right off the top. Watch, I'll do it. I know you don't trust me. I'll do it slowly. Look, right off the top. All right, I'll do it a little. I'll do it with one hand. All right, watch, right off the top. See, I know you don't trust me. Why don't you take my card off for me and put it right there? Yeah, fine. Yeah, just to show you that there's no monkey business. Look, I wouldn't kid you for the world. All right?" And then I said, "When I play cards, I like to see what I'm playing against. For example, I gave this guy either a pair of tens or four, five, six for a possible straight, because I know him. He's going to stay in no matter what. I gave this guy three hearts. I know he's going to go for the flush. This guy, I gave a pair of nines, and I knew he would stay in. And I gave this guy a pair of eights and a pair of nines, two pair. But at this point, the older guy stopped me and said, 'Wait a minute, Harry, hold it. Wait a minute. I see three aces out here.' He said, 'How in the world can you have four aces in your hand unless you've got a deck with seven aces, and that's not honest?' I said, 'Well, my friend, you misunderstood me. I didn't say I would get the four aces necessarily. I said I would get the winning hand, and I have the hand that can't possibly be both beaten in poker, a royal flush in spades.'" Yeah.
Thank you.